Hello, I am Alen Plehancik, the lead designer of Tuner software, and I'm proud to announce the release of Tuner 3.0. Today I'll be answering the questions, what's included with these changes, why we did this, how is this going to affect Simucube 2 users, and what can you look forward into the future. The first thing you may notice when you launch 3.0 is the visual redesign. The color has been changed and we have improved the user experience in some areas. You may also notice the profile handling has been changed. When you select a profile, you can notice on the left side that we have put them in their own sections, such as local, my profiles, or there is also Simucube presets. In the future, we will be expanding this feature to allow you to create your own sections. The third thing we introduced with these changes is the slider handling. So now you can input manually the value you want into the slider instead of trying to tinker with the pixels and trying to get the value you truly want. Last but not the least, we expanded the telemetry data for our supported titles. So why did we do all these changes? Firstly, because you gave us really great feedback on your pain points when you use Tuner software, and we wanted to solve all those issues. Secondly, we wanted to celebrate the release of our Simucube 3 wheelbases. Let's hear more about how Simucube 3 works in Tuner 3.0 from our senior software developer, Iiro Leino.
When we started designing Simucube 3, we wanted to take a bit bolder approach and not be limited by old ways of doing things. The firmware in Simucube 3 is not derived from Simucube 2, as we saw places where we could improve. This also covers the feel of the wheelbase. It all starts on how we drive the motor and ends up on how we deliver the force feedback signals to the motor for users to experience. With our new approach, we are aiming to keep the feel as same as possible across the whole lineup when the same settings are used. One of our main goals was to make Simucube 3 very intuitive without sacrificing more detailed features for users who want more control over different settings of their wheelbase. We optimized on how to get good force feedback feeling on Simucube 3 right away. The force feedback torque and feel can be adjusted by one slider each, and that is enough for many people to get a good feeling for their driving experience. You're not limited by these two sliders for the feel, as you can also go deeper to fine-tune on how similar force feedback signal is handled to get the exact feel you want. In addition, there's also a fading and boosting possibilities for the signal. To get a feel what these settings do, we added simulation buttons so users can feel without starting up the simulator. So you can now just use the slider, adjust the setting, and then feel what you just done. We also added a custom-made telemetry effect possibilities to wheelbase, like ABS and motor vibration effect. For these, we added a lot of adjustment possibilities as we did with our active pedal before. In addition, there is mechanical feel section where you can adjust the bass feel of the Simucube 3 before the force feedback signals are added to it. We felt limited in how, for example, damping is usually only controlled by its strength, as we know the speed of the wheelbase is also another factor in it. So we implemented the possibility of curve control, which we previously showcased in our active pedal control design. We added this to multiple control elements, so you can set parameters based on another parameter. This gives you more precise control on how certain features behave. Overall, in Tuner 3, I would like to point out two big quality of life improvements. We added tooltips for each control, so it is clear for users what each setting does. And we also added more complicated feature sliders, which can be used normally as before, but also are text inputs, so you can just write the number you like and that way easily adjust the exact value you want. There are already a lot of features, but we will still make more and keep improving the existing features. We did a lot of back and forth in Tuner 3 development to optimize different ideas. And in conclusion, in my opinion, we created the best application for controlling the simulator device settings, and I'm proud of what our team achieved.
We have put a lot of effort in Tuner 3.0 and Simucube 3. However, we know that you have a lot of questions regarding Simucube 2 and how it has been affected. Rest assured, the visual redesign is also applied to Simucube 2. Here is our legend Mika Takala to tell you more about what may occur in future for Simucube 2.
Thanks, Alan. Well, Simucube 2 is an older product, and all the things that we have done for Simucube Link products, the whole ecosystem, including how we develop it, is completely new, and all our developers are enjoying it very much. Whereas Simucube 2 is based on something that we already did for Simucube 1 in 2017 and 18, but we want to support our old products and of course the huge user base we have for Simucube 2. We very much would like to use the same communication interface, Simucube Link, on the Simucube 2 wheelbase as well, but we are not sure if they can be fit into the USB processor on the Simucube 2. It's not full yet, but there's not too much space left. And until we have done some investigations, we cannot really say that how easy it will be to implement telemetry on Simucube 2. We are quite confident that we are able to bring something to the Simucube 2 regarding telemetry effects and telemetry force feedback. We are starting to investigation, so stay tuned for more updates on this.
We are proud of what we have achieved so far with the Tuner 3.0, and there is so much more for the future of the Tuner software, such as Paddock. Then there is language support. We will start with German, go to Portuguese, Spanish, Italian, French, and along the way, more languages. We're also introducing first-time user experience to help new users with our software, and there is so much more coming in the future. Please enjoy our Tuner 3.0 update. If you have any kind of ideas or feedback, feel free to join our Discord. We're always listening to our community.